would like to ask you, based upon your recent talk in the CSI Kolkata, in patients who are having the prosthetic mitral valve and are on VKA, if are subjected to the elective surgery, what is your recommendation as far as the treatment with VKA is concerned?
When a patient with a prosthetic mitral valve is undergoing a non-cardiac surgery, he has a high risk for thromboembolism, especially if the prosthetic valve in the mitral position. So the perioperative management of anticoagulation is very important. Unfortunately, there are no randomized controlled trials in this area to guide the treating physician, and also always the clinician is faced with a dilemma. But there are many guidelines and recommendations. It is almost certain that all patients with prosthetic mitral valve undergoing a major surgery, the anticoagulant should be stopped 5 days before the date of surgery, preferably. It can vary. The days when they are to be stopped vary depending upon the type of anticoagulant they are using. If they are using a short-acting or if they are using an anticoagulant with a shorter half-life, then they can need to wait, stop only for a few days. But if it is the usual warfarin, they will have to stop 5 days before.
Okay, sir.
And the INR should be checked every day. Then you can give oral vitamin K, 1 to 2.5 milligram. Then check the INR again on the day of surgery. The day of surgery, the INR should be less than 1.5. If the INR is still less than more than 1.5, the surgery will have to be deferred.
Okay, sir. So, sir, during this period of VKA intervention, what will be the further line of management in such patients?
When the patients taking vitamin K antagonist, they are off vitamin K antagonist, there is always a small risk of thromboembolism. This risk of thromboembolism vary depending upon the type of surgery, type of the patient, and the type of the valve also. So to prevent this, in most situations, some sort of bridging will be required. The bridging is usually done with either unfractionated heparin or low molecular weight heparin. And this bridging starts on the next day after stopping vitamin K antagonist. For example, if the vitamin K antagonist is stopped 5 days before, if it is unfractionated heparin, the bridging heparin is continued till 6 hours before surgery. If it is low molecular weight heparin, it should be stopped more than 12 hours before surgery.
Okay.
And then the vitamin K antagonists are also restarted.
Okay.
And then both are continued, heparin as well as vitamin K antagonists are continued till the INR reaches therapeutic range.
Okay, sir. So, sir, do you think that there is need for individualization of the therapy?
Oh, yes, there is, because the type of valve is different, some type of surgery is different, the risk of bleeding has to be considered. So each patient will be different. So when deciding on stopping and deciding on bridging and the duration, we have to consider several factors, and the treatment has to be individualized.
Right, sir. So, sir, what will be your final message to the practitioners for managing any patients who are on VKA and undergoing any elective surgery?
When a patient on vitamin K antagonist therapy with the prosthetic valve, extreme care has to be taken when the patients are being taken up for surgery, because there is a double risk, a risk of thromboembolism and risk of bleeding. So you cannot err in this. So a proper evaluation and a standardized protocol should be followed. The patient and the protocol being followed, and it should be monitored very closely. That is my message.
Okay. So thank you so much, sir, for such an informative talk. Thank you so much.